Welcome back to The Lead. Time now for our buried lead. That's what we call stories that we feel are not getting enough attention. For generations, we've all been regaled with tales of American spies and special forces saving the day. But long before the likes of SEAL Team 6, there were the heroes of the OSS, or Office of Strategic Services. This was a clandestine intelligence agency fighting evil in the shadows. Brave men and women instrumental in the Allied victory in World War II. This week, Congress will have the opportunity to finally honor their service and sacrifice with congressional gold medals, more than 70 years after they helped win the day.
When you get your hair cut, be sure it's enemy area style. The hands must look as if they've done the work. Every scar must conform with your cover story.
These World War II training films could be taken right from a spy thriller.
The identities of the recruits remain a carefully guarded secret, which explains the use of masks in this film.
But the dangerous missions and secrecy of the military intelligence agency they were made for were all too real. The Office of Strategic Services, or OSS, was the 1940s precursor to the modern CIA, the Navy SEALs, and U.S. Special Forces Command. Its members were tasked with some of the most important and covert assignments in the war.
We weren't even supposed to mention that we were with OSS. The less people that know, the safer it is for all of us. I was a good boy. I didn't talk about it to anybody.
Now, more than seven decades later, with the help of the OSS Society, legislation finally might pass to recognize members of the OSS, such as Captain John Billings, with a Congressional Gold Medal, the highest civilian honor.
To me, it means that at least somebody thinks we did a good job.
Billings had already flown countless bombing missions for the U.S. Army during World War II when he was recruited to the OSS at age 21. His assignment? To fly operatives and other agents and supplies to drop zones within enemy territory, some marked in the snow with letters, such as this one.
We weren't supposed to learn their names. Occasionally we'd drop Joe's. Everybody's name that got on that was not going to come back with us was named Joe. You, as a single plane, were probably shortening the war much more than hundreds of planes just dropping bombs, hoping to hit a factory or something of that sort. The OSS was very powerful, and we liked it.
Billings says perhaps his most daring mission was Operation Greenup in 1945. He flew three Joes deep into the Austrian Alps to parachute out behind enemy lines and gather information on the Nazis. Two of the men were Jewish, including the late German-born spy Fred Mayer, a close friend of Billings whose work inspired the film Inglourious Basterds.
I need me eight soldiers. Eight Jewish American soldiers. We're going to be dropped into France dressed as civilians.
Billings tells CNN that the film's fictional portrayal missed the real bravery and aptitude of OSS members such as Mayer.
These people, especially the people that went out of the airplane, they were going into unknown things, and they had, especially Fred, had chutzpah.
The kind that Congress may finally honor, though much too late for far too many members of this greatest generation.
I would have liked to have had this medal knowing that he was going to get one too.
Thank you, Captain Billings. The vote to recognize the brave men and women of the OSS with a Congressional Gold Medal is set to take place tomorrow in the House of Representatives. Some surviving members are expected to attend.